see you. When I get a look at the vendor, I just want to see everybody. Nice to see you guys. Thank you so much for coming out. It's really delightful to see you. Thank you so, so much.
Look,
how are you?
Look at you. Is this not a fine specimen of a human being?
Well, look at them. Look how they dress the
crowd. Look, we got it up in them.
Yeah. Thank you, Andrew.
So it is absolutely amazing that you joined us here today, because you have had kind of a whirlwind week.
Yes, as you know, but maybe you don't know. You know what I did? Well, after you were in Los Angeles, because we went to the Capitol Records building. You know that building in Los Angeles? Very famous, pagoda-looking building where Frank Sinatra and the Beatles and the Rolling Stones and Nat King Cole made records. I have a jazz band. I play jazz piano, and I have a little band, and we made a record there. The Decca is going to come out with.
So excited. It was terrific. And thank you, Julie, for inviting me back.
You're so sweet. Your sweet wife, Tracy, she's not just great. And your daughter's getting married.
My daughter's getting married next Saturday. Yeah. You're welcome to attend if you can fit it in.
No, I was going to surprise you. I'm going to sing that song to you. Only just because. Five nice and promises. So then we made that record, and then the next morning I flew to Tokyo, where I met with Wes Anderson was there, and we were doing publicity for Isle of Dogs.
Oh,
love that.
Great. And then?
And then I went right from there to London, and Bryce Dallas Howard and Chris Pratt, and Colin Trevorrow, who wrote directed the last one, and who wrote this one, and then J.A. Bayona, who directed this one, Fallen Kingdom, were there, and we did a couple of days press on that. And I'm going to go to Hawaii in like a week to do more press on that. As you can imagine, these big movies do lots of press, and like that.
It doesn't slow down. So,
no, I just came here right from London.
And on June 8th is Hotel Artemis.
Hotel Artemis, that's June 8th, that's right. With the wonderful Jodie Foster, that's right, and Sterling K. Brown.
Yeah. And then, I'm giving your whole schedule to these people here, so you can see. And this deserves a round of applause. On June 14th, this man is getting a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
That's so sweet, thank you very much. Have you been to Los Angeles and Hollywood and walked those streets and said, you can? And did you see the stars on the street? Did you like those? They're nice to see up close, aren't they? Hey, well, I'm going to have that.
Yeah. And then June 22nd, of course, Jurassic World comes out.
It's June 22nd. Right.
We get to see Dr. Ian Malcolm again.
Dr. Ian Malcolm, yes. I have a little thing in this, but it's always nice to play that heart. You know why? Because even though the movies are very fun and great dinosaurs, and they're scary and everything, I like that character.
Yeah.
I like that character. You know, I'll bet in the intervening couple decades, Ian Malcolm has been a prolific author of books. I'll bet he's writing about innovative environmental protection and animal rights and the glories of science, and solving problems without violence, and maybe trying his hand at some poetry. And then in these movies, sometimes I get a chance to make a remark or two from my thinking and feeling. It's a very interesting part and a big responsibility.
We look forward to much more of that as well. But if you folks ever need your daily dose of Jeff Goldblum, God, the internet is just blowing up over you with everything. Hour-long videos, 10-hour-long videos of you purring. You making your different Goldblumisms, as they call them, all the blooms, the haws, the... And something that's just come up. And here's the beauty of these panels. Jeff is the world's greatest improviser. We don't talk about anything ahead of time. If I ever go to him and say, hey, Jeff, I want to Don't tell me about it. So there is something I have made up, and you haven't seen it.
No, this I didn't know you were going to impress me with anything. I like this.
Can you get can you get in on this? Can you get Tyler? Yeah. What? So, we have a Jeff Goldblum Life Finds a Way cereal.
Now, who made that? Who, I think I've seen that on Instagram, because I go to hashtag Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah.
We're looking, in case we take some pictures, I'll be looking, last time I did these, I like to see our pictures together. And I think about our experience, and I think about each and every one of you.
I do.
I see them all. And sometimes I go to your stack, and I see all your other pictures. I do.
And then something else on the internet that I recently pulled off. 10 reasons Jeff Goldblum is the coolest man alive. Like, they limited it to 10. So the first one, he has the best taste in eyewear ever. It says you have allegedly worn over 1,000 pair of eyeglasses.
No, I haven't worn 1,000 pair of eyeglasses. That can't be true. But I have, over the course of my long or short life, I've experimented with many glasses, but I'm a minimalist. I like to get rid of it in my private collection. I only have a half a dozen or something like that. But I recently got a few more, including this one here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very nice.
You like these?
I do like those, yeah.
I'm a little myopic. I actually need glasses. You know, I'm good if I can see this very well. But to see you, you're a little blurry, so I need that. So I like these. You know what? You know where I get this? Can you guess who makes these? I don't know if you're interested in glasses. Can you guess who makes these? I'm sure you won't. Because they're kind of a, you know, boutique kind of company.
Yes.
Jacques-Marie Maje. If you look up Jacques, like the French Jacques-Marie, M-A-R-I-E, Maje, M-A-G-E, that's what these glasses are. I like them very, very much. Glasses. Here's glasses, here's without glasses. Applause for without glasses. Pause with glasses. That's very helpful. Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right, the next one, you touched on this. He plays in a jazz band and they have weekly shows. You can go to LA any point and see you playing in a bar.
You can come see us. You can come see us. If you get to LA the next time you want to see the Walk of Fame or come around, and you're there on a Wednesday night, if I'm there in town and I'm working, we have a residency or a weekly gig at a place called Rockwell. That's all you have to remember. Google Rockwell, like Sam Rockwell, and show up and tap me on the shoulder when you get there. It's very intimate. And
yeah,
I'll play jazz music.
Jeff Goldblum and the Mildred Snitzer Orchestra. Really looking forward to that album coming out. The next one says he stands 6'4" and has a pretty exclusive club in Hollywood of big and tall actors. 6'4".
Yeah, that's not so freakishly tall. That's not so.
It's not freakishly tall, but when we embrace, when we do these panels, I feel like a child. I feel like I'm being warmed by your embrace. It's so.
I love to wrap my encouraging arms around you. But you're a lovely knight. You're 5'11". You're 6.
Oh, no. I'm 5'9" and I'm a bit.
Perfect. That's the movie star height. That's most great movie stars. Paul Newman and Steve McQueen. I'm sure with that. Tom Cruise. You know how tall Tom Cruise is? Actual size? 4'11". Maybe so. I don't know.
It says you've never had a filling or a cavity.
That's absolutely true.
You have a poodle named Woody Allen Goldblum. That's true. Yeah. And you are a dog person. You love dogs. You're getting another one, aren't you? You're telling me?
Emily would like another dog, my sweet wife. Emily, yeah. Yes, we might. But There's chaos in our house, I don't know. I mean, two kids and the dog we have, he's a standard poodle, red-haired standard poodle, Woody. And he's a doll, he's the sweetest, sweetest doll. He sleeps with us, he's very protective of the kids. And, but I don't know, yeah, she wants another, yeah, she'd like another puppy.
Jeff Goldblumisms are a real thing. And we talked about this, the Oz, the Hums, they're becoming a form of a pseudo language.
You should hear of our kids. Boy, they make a lot of funny sounds. And I just told the story the other day on the Grand Norton. I was in there. I said, my dad used to use this expression. Has anybody ever heard? Because my dad used to say this. I used to go to the kitchen after we would eat, and I, you know, help rub the, you know, clean the pots and pans. But I would kind of, you know, do that, you know. And he'd say, hey, Jeff, use asses and elbows. Asses and elbows. Really? Get in there. Really? Get your asses and elbows. So I say that to Charlie because he brushes his teeth like that. I say, Charlie, come on, asses and elbows, asses and elbows. And now he says, asses and elbows. And then he came up the other day. He said, something, I said, you like those pancakes? He says, yes, never in my life, he said, have I had such a good time.
Oh my goodness.
Like, what really? Never in your long life.
And that leads to actually to the next one. It says, your first child, Charlie Ocean, was born on July 4th, Independence Day.
While I was making, and he was born during the shoot, this is like 2.5 years ago, of last Independence Day. I came home to participate in the birth with my wife. From the set, we were shooting in Albuquerque, New Mexico. It was about an hour's flight, but I had, you know, I was very nervous. I had, you know, flights standing by, and, you know, I got home, and I didn't miss it.
And now you have River Joe as well?
River Joe, yes. I was there for that birth as well. I helped out too. Has anybody ever, you've had children and been in the delivery room? That's something, isn't it?
Yeah.
And your daughter, were you there when your daughter was born?
I was there. My daughter was born premature. I was there.
Oh.
Yeah.
How premature?
6 weeks. Not too bad.
Okay.
Yeah. But I was there.
And did you help out? Were you right there?
I was there. Yeah, you know, I remember crystal clear. I was there, then everything went black, and then I woke up in the room.
Yeah.
I remember like yesterday.
You fainted?
No, I didn't. Yeah, I was going to say it was a miracle. I love it.
It's such a miracle. It is something, but it's something. Yeah, it's something. It's something. My wife is a she was in the Olympics for Canada. She does rhythmic gymnastics and Cirque du Soleil stuff. So she's a contortionist. She's a contortionist. So she was the first child. They were having trouble getting it out. His shoulder was stuck and stuff. So she got her legs way back over behind her head. I held one. My job was to hold one. So I held one. She's doing it back, and I was right. Her face was right there, and she was pushing, and she has little fine, little beautiful blonde hairs on her neck, and they were all, I've never seen it before like it. They were all standing straight out.
That's what happened to you in the fly. In the fly, all those little hairs, I remember that.
That's right, a different kind. This is a very
different kind.
It's a beautiful, beautiful hair. I had a few coarse fly hairs on my back.
Yeah. I think this one might get a reaction. It says, Jeff Goldblum is the epitome of a silver fox. It says he has better taste in clothing at 65 than most men do at 30. GQ magazine in Britain. He is on the cover this month. It'll be out in a week or so.
There's GQ, yeah. I took some nice little pictures in that, yeah. Yes. And a guy came over to the house and wrote a very sweet story about me.
So nice.
Nice.
And I'm going to finish with this one. He exudes charm, sex appeal, and wholesomeness.
Wholesomeness, too. I'm a little bit wholesome, aren't I? Yes.
Well, we're going to put that to the test, because recently on the internet, you read some tweets, and we got the chance to do it in Calgary. Well, guess what, Jeff? I went online, and I pulled some off, and again, you've never seen these. These are real tweets that over the last little while people have tweeted under hashtag Jeff Goldblum, hashtag Jeff Goldblum's hot, hashtag I love Jeff Goldblum, hashtag I wanna have a number of that one. Why don't you have a pick through a few of them? Why don't you
scared? I hope this isn't embarrassing. Alright, I'm gonna get through all of them. I don't have a note matter.
Alright.
Number one, Jeff Goldblum. This is so somebody wrote this in. This is a tweet.
These are all tweet. Everyone is someone wrote them in.
Yeah, I've never seen these. Jeff Goldblum never responded to my lunch proposal. It's time to cut some toxic people out of my life. Sorry, Jeff. very funny. I'm sorry. Well, I'm sorry. Number two. I recently bought a Jeff Goldblum shower curtain. He has seen my every nook and cranny. Yeah, most people don't know those shower curtains aren't hooked up, so I can watch them. I watch everybody in the shower. Yeah, that's how I spend most of my days. Just tuned in to somebody else taking a shower.
I don't think you're lying. I believe you.
Oh my gosh. Okay, number three. Just embarrassed myself in a cinema full of people because I full on squealed when Jeff Goldblum made an appearance in the new Jurassic World trailer.
Yeah.
Excellent, thank you. Number four. Jeff Goldblum always looks like he knows something that I don't. And I'm willing to do anything to find out what it is he knows.
My wife said that about him. She said he knows something. The way he just looks at you, look, see, he's got this look.
She's not willing to do anything to find out what I hope not either. Let's see, number five. I don't know why you grafted this because these are all hard while I say that. Five, if I could choose one person to narrate my life, I would pick Jeff Goldblum.
Yes.
And then quote, because I guess this is what I would say. I don't think I'm, so different than your average. .. Number six, Jeff Goldblum could punch me in the face with his 15 rings on, and I would gladly tell him to do it again. Look at the rings. I only have, how many are there? She says 15. No, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, then you have to punch her 3 times. I don't know, when I started to wear rings, I was never a ring-wearing fella, but I somehow got this hankering for rings.
Yeah,
I don't know what. I don't know what. You like them? Is it too dandified? Let's see.
Who do I like who wears rings?
Lenny Kravitz.
Oh, Lenny Kravitz wears a lot of rings. Keith Richards wears a lot of rings.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway. Number seven. If I can undergo some sort of operation to have Jeff Goldblum's voice, I would do it faster than you can say life finds a way.
An hour video, I'm not kidding, go on YouTube, 10-hour video, purring.
Hey, I get to, this is only the beginning of the day. I've met some of these people because I've signed autographs so far, so I've seen some of you, yes, and I remember each and every one of you. And now we're going to do some pictures, we're going to do some photos, and some more autographs, and we're going to spend the rest of the day together, just hanging out, you and I.
That's going to be a good day.
Yeah, one-on-one, close personal relationships. Okay, number eight. I would totally let Jeff Goldblum tear me apart like a velociraptor feasting on a triceratops, and I would love every minute of it.
Oh.
would too. I would. Maybe I will when we take pictures.
Maybe you will.
Alright, let's see. And finally, 9. Oh, this is good. I'm going to get a tramp stamp in honor of my favorite guy, the Grandmaster. I can't wait to have Jeff Goldblum's face on my ass. And that's it.
And that's it. Nick is going to do it. Here, where do I get this? Why don't you sign it for some people? Give that a signature. That's a great keepsake. We'll give this one to them. Yeah, the ten reasons that and I think this one might frizz me